Back to continue our conversation now with Sheriff Mike Kanellakis and former commander, Mr. Fred Garcia.
Sheriff, I want to direct this question to you. Listening to all of this, as you know, to play the devil's advocate, how does one run against an incumbent if you cannot disagree with the incumbent? I guess that would be my question to you.
I'm glad you asked that, Aaron. That's a great question. And I would just say that in a situation such as this, the right thing to do would be to resign, to retire, and to speak out if you felt that strong about your convictions. And failing in that, bring it forward. If you've got grievances, if you've got issues within the department, bring it up through the chain of command. Talk to your commanding officer or talk to me. Garcia never did that. And had he done that and had we had a conversation, who knows? But to answer your question specifically, I think it's really important that when you run a campaign, you run on your experience, you run on your qualifications for office, and you run on your vision. What are you going to do to make this a safer county and make the people of Monterey County safer?
Mr. Garcia, I can see you sort of chafing at the bit there. Do you want to respond?
Well, first of all, I want to step back a bit. I apologize rather than addressing the immediate question. First of all, the sheriff makes a comment that my name wasn't on the original report. The sergeant's name was on the report. And that's one key difference between the sheriff and me. I recognize people for doing good work. And the sergeant in this case did the work. He deserves a credit. He deserves to have his name. The sheriff likes to have his name on everything. That's the difference between he and I. I put people and employees of the sheriff's department first, all before me. Now we talk about this issue of the helicopter. The reality is everyone in the sheriff's office know that the helicopter is the sheriff's baby. It's no one else. It's his. Now, for him to say, come on TV and say that I could have come and talked to him and maybe he would have changed his mind, well, I really don't think so. Now, the whole issue is that I'm running for office. I'm running for office. The sheriff wants to talk about what my record is, what my experience is, and I do that. But I also talk about the issues of what I think he has failed to do as sheriff. So the question is, I would ask the sheriff, says, do I have a right to talk about issues of the department or not? Do I not have the rights to talk about what I think you have failed to do as sheriff? It's a very simple First Amendment rights question to you.
And the issue has been whether or not that happened within the bounds of department policy. So what we're going to do is we're going to give both of you 30 seconds to wrap up your thoughts and get your last word in. And we'll start with you, Mr. Garcia.
The reality is this whole investigation came down to the fact of the sheriff losing the helicopter program and my opposition to it. I did it as a candidate, and I did it under the right of free speech. Under free speech, people need to understand that as law enforcement, public safety, it's our job to serve the community and follow the rule of law. And unfortunately, the sheriff doesn't want to believe that the rule of law also includes the right to free speech. He wants to silence me. He wants to say what I can say, what I can't say. The reality is the citizens of Monterey County have a right and an obligation to know what's going on within the sheriff's department and what the issues are. But the sheriff doesn't want me to do that. He just wants to talk about, well, I've been there for 29 years and that's it.
All right.
All right, Mr. Garcia, we thank you. Sheriff Kanellakis, we're going to give you the last word.
Well, I appreciate that. And I just want to say that this has been an interesting interview. I think that, and I hope that the viewers have learned something here tonight. But my main concern tonight is trying to obtain and find out what happened to that confidential employee roster, which I'm extremely concerned about. If we can get past retired Commander Garcia's constant talking about the First Amendment and understand that he had a duty and responsibility to carry out his assigned tasks, and he failed to do so. If we can get past that, there's much more important things in this county that we need to be addressing and besides his misconduct. So I would look to the future. I would look to tell the people of Monterey County what's going to make them safer. We still have a huge gang problem in this county. We have a huge drug problem in this county, and we've got to do something about the Monterey County Jail. And I think those are the issues that the voters would really like to hear about.
And we will look forward to giving both you and certainly Mr. Miller the opportunity to talk about those publicly as the campaign goes forward. Gentlemen, thank you both for your time today.
Thank you.
We also want to let you know, if you want to check out the documents that Mr. Garcia has released to the public, they are on our website, so you can read them in their entirety at ksbw.com.